Have you ever found yourself needing to add more sensors to a data logger than the available terminals on the data logger will allow? If so, adding a multiplexer, such as the AM1632B, may be the solution you need. Hello, I'm Collin Daly. The AM1632B multiplexer adds additional measurement terminals to a single data logger. Up to 32 terminal pairs are available on each multiplexer, and more than one multiplexer may be added to a data logger, allowing even more sensor connections to a single data logger. In this video, I will show you how to create a program and shortcut that uses the AM1632B to measure additional sensors. Once the program is created, I'll show you how to wire the sensors to the AM1632B to work with your new program. I'll begin by using Shortcut to create a CRBasic program. Shortcut is included with PC400 or LoggerNet available from Campbell Scientific. PC400 is freely downloadable directly from Campbell Scientific's website. I'll use PC400 in this example, where we will be measuring air temperature with thermocouples. Open PC400 and select the red shortcut icon. Shortcut opens. Begin by selecting Create New Program. A list of current Campbell Scientific data loggers appears. Select the CR1000X series data logger, then select Next. By default, the data logger will take measurements of the data logger battery voltage, BatV, and the wiring panel temperature, PTEMPC. I'll use this panel temperature as a reference temperature when measuring the thermocouples. Now add the multiplexer. I'm adding the AM1632B. Locate it under Devices and add it to the measurements by selecting it, then selecting the Add button. There are now two tabs under Available Sensors and Devices. Any sensors I add to the program will be added to the active device shown on the tab below the sensor list. If I want to add something to the CR1000X, I will select the CR1000X tab. To add sensors to the multiplexer, select the AM1632 tab. Locate the Type T thermocouple and add it to the project. A new window opens where I can configure the thermocouples. I could add up to 32 thermocouples if needed, but for this example, I'll change the number of sensors to 3. These measurements will be in degrees Celsius, so TempC is an acceptable name, though it can be changed to a more descriptive name if needed. PTempC, which is the data logger panel temperature, was added to the CR1000X measurements by default. In this example, I'll use PTemp as a reference temperature measurement. The advanced options can be enabled here if additional control over a measurement is required. Select OK. Three Type T thermocouples now appear under AM1632. Now I need to set up measurement outputs for each thermocouple. Select Next to move to the Output Setup screen. This screen is where the scan interval is set and the data tables are configured. It is recommended to set the interval to at least 30 seconds when using a multiplexer to extend the life of the mechanical relays inside the multiplexer. Set the scan interval to 30 seconds. I will rename Table 1 to Hourly and Table 2 to Daily to match the default storage intervals. I could add more tables here as well if I needed them. Select Next. The Output Select screen is where the output measurements from each sensor are selected. The sensors are shown on the left, available measurements in the center, and the measurements to be stored in each table on the right. For this example, I will select the minimum battery voltage for each interval. I don't need to know the exact time the minimum was measured, so I will say no when given the option. For the panel temperature and the three thermocouples, I will choose to record the average temperature for each interval. I will record the same measurement in both tables. Now that I have all my outputs defined, I can save my program. Select Finish. Give the program a name and save it to the computer. As soon as it's saved, the option to send the program to the data logger will pop up. Select No because I want to view the wiring diagram before sending the program. Select Wiring Diagram on the left side to view the diagram. There are two tabs for the example program. The first tab shows the wire connections between the CR1000X data logger and the AM1632B multiplexer. The second tab shows the three thermocouples wired to the AM1632B. As the thermocouples have specifically colored wires, they are shown in the wiring diagram. I can also view a text version of how the data logger and multiplexer are wired. Again, there are two tabs, one for the data logger and one for the multiplexer. By referring to the wiring diagram, I can make all the wire connections I need for the program to function. Take a moment and complete the wiring as shown in the wiring diagrams. Begin by connecting power to the AM1632B. Attach a red wire between the 12V terminal on the CR1000X and the 12V terminal on the AM1632B. Next, connect a black wire between the G ground terminal on the data logger to the G ground terminal on the multiplexer. Connect the data logger C1 terminal to the CLK or clock terminal on the multiplexer. I'll use a blue wire. Now connect the C2 terminal to the RES or reset terminal. For the measurement, connect 1H on the data logger to COM-ODD-H on the multiplexer using one wire from an unsoldered thermocouple. When the reference temperature is on the data logger, the signal wire between the data logger and the AM1632B must be on the same wire type as a thermocouple with the same polarity. Connect 1L to COM-ODD-L with the remaining thermocouple wire and ground to COM-GROUND with a black wire. Finally, attach 3 Type-T thermocouples to the first 3 terminals on the multiplexer, blue wires to the H terminals, and the red stripe wires to the L terminals. Check the mode switch on the multiplexer and make sure it is in the 2x32 position. This will allow up to 32 thermocouples to be attached to the multiplexer. Note that if I was measuring 4 wire sensors, I would set the mode switch to 4x16. Connect power to the data logger and connect the data logger to the computer with a USB cable. Close shortcut and click on the Connect/Disconnect button on the main toolbar in PC400. It's time to send my program to the data logger. First, I'll need to connect to the data logger. If I have connected to the data logger before, its icon will appear below the Connect button. If not, select the Add Data Logger button. See Part 2 of our CR1000X or CR350 Quick Start video series to see how to add a new data logger to LoggerNet or PC400. The Easy Setup Wizard closes and I'm now connected to the CR1000X. Select Send Program on the far right of the PC400 window. A warning will pop up about data files being deleted and ask if I want to proceed. Select Yes. I need to browse to where the program I created is saved. Highlight that program and select Open. The program is sent to the data logger where it is compiled and begins to run. Select the Monitor Data tab to see the measurement results of the program. I need to allow at least 30 seconds to elapse before I will see any data. Now I see 3 measurements coming from the thermocouples, so I know the program is working. And that's it. My data logger and multiplexer are working together to take multiple thermocouple measurements. If you have any questions about Campbell Scientific data loggers or multiplexers, visit our website, read the manual, or contact Campbell Scientific directly, and we'll be happy to answer your question.